Hey folks, welcome back. So today we're going to start talking about light. Now I mentioned that light is all we get from the stars, and so we've got to squeeze every tiny little piece of information out of this light that we can possibly get. So before we can do that, we've got to talk about what are the properties of a light. What is the different things, like how much, we're going to talk about frequency, we're going to talk about its wavelength, but the key thing we're going to talk about is how much energy that light has, because that's going to give us a lot of the information that we're looking for from that. So what we're going to do in this lesson is we'll talk about those three major properties. In the next lecture, we'll talk about the different types of light so that you can see, even though all of these lights seem to be used for different things, have different properties, it really is all the same thing. It all is all just light, but it's got different energies, and that's going to make the big difference. So let's get started. As always, make sure that you've got your class notes out here. Remember, it's a double-sided page. It's going to look like this on both sides. So pause the video until you're ready to have that going, because we're going to be writing on that quite a bit today. All right. So as I mentioned, all we get in astronomy from the stars is light. But that it turns out that light can tell us an incredible amount of information about what's going on with the stars. So let's look at some of the properties of light. So somebody says, well, what is light? Well, okay, the technical answer is it's an oscillating electromagnetic field. Say what? Well, you know, we don't need to get into all the technical details of it, but yeah, I mean, if you take a magnet and you wiggle it back and forth, you're creating light. You're actually creating very low frequency radio waves when you do that, but you're creating light. But for practical purposes, something that's a little more useful is that it's a wave or a particle, we'll talk about that in a minute, that carries energy. Now, you may have heard that light is a wave and also a particle, but this gets into quantum mechanics and things that we're not going to have to deal with. For most of this class, we can treat light as a wave. So it's just this wave that's traveling through space, but the key thing is that it's carrying energy. Photons also carry energy. So, you know, later on in the class, if we talk about solar sails and things like that, light can be thought of as a little particle, a photon that's bouncing off of things. But for most of the things we're going to be talking about, we're going to think of light as a wave. And so that's kind of the primary thing that I want you to keep in mind. So there's three main characteristics. So frequency, that's the length from peak to peak. So if this is my wave, it's the distance between those two peaks. I'll show you a diagram of that in a minute. Frequency is the number of peaks per second. So it's kind of how fast it's wiggling. And then energy is how much energy is carried in the wave as it comes across. How many ping pong balls are hitting you every time one of those waves hits you? A key thing that I want you to remember, do not be fooled. All light travels at the speed of light. We'll show you that in just a second. So looking at wavelength then, look on your class notes here. Here we've got two waves. We're going to call this a radio wave. It's not, but it's close enough. So let's say that this is a radio wave and this is a gamma ray. The wavelength is the distance from the peak to the peak. So here it would be peak to peak, and that will be the same distance as the peak from here to here, or from here to here. Okay. What you never ever want to do is do the distance from the top to the bottom. That's actually only half of the wave, so that's going to give you the wrong answer. So from peak to peak. All right, so look on your chart, on your class notes, which of these has the longest wavelength, radio or gamma rays? Pause the video, think about it, and go ahead and mark your sheet. All right, hopefully this one was fairly straightforward. If you look, the peak from here to here is quite a bit longer than the peak from here to here. So radio has a longer wavelength. So radio waves can be anywhere from maybe the human size or a little longer, all the way up to the size of a mountain or the size of the United States. It just depends upon, you know, how long that frequency is. When I was in the Navy, we were talking to submarines, and so we had to use radio waves that had such a long wavelength, we had to have a 5-mile-long antenna that went out the back of the aircraft, because only those really long wavelengths could penetrate the seawater and talk to the submarines. On the opposite side, gamma rays have a very, very short wavelength, you know, roughly the size of an atomic nucleus. And, of course, that's one reason why they're so dangerous, is because they're the same size as your DNA. And so they're getting there and directly damaging your DNA with that. Visible light, the kind of light that your eye is sensitive to, is on the order, the wavelengths are on the order of about a billionth of a meter. So, you know, if you think about this being a meter, cut that into a billion pieces, and that's how many wavelengths that we've got. And then, as I said, don't be fooled. all kinds of light travel at the same speed. And there's a lot of things in Smart Sparrow and some of the other things that will trip you up. Make sure that you remember all light travels at the same speed. Radio waves, gamma rays, visible light, everything travels at 3 × 10⁸ meters per second because it's the speed of light. And the next thing we talk about is frequency. Frequency is the number of these peaks that's hitting each second. And so let's suppose that I've got these waves coming in, and every time one of these peaks hits my eye, I get a beep. Now remember, they're traveling at the same speed. So the radio then, I would get beep, 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 beep. Whereas with the gamma rays, I'd get beep, 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 beep. So you see, I'm going to get more beeps per second. So which then has the highest frequency? Radio or gamma rays? Pause the video and then mark it on your sheet. So you see, I'm getting more beeps per second. I've got more waves passing by per second with the gamma ray. So the gamma ray is going to have the highest frequency. So radio has roughly 100 million peaks per second. And that sounds like a lot, and it is. But even with these very long wavelengths, because the speed of light is so fast, you still get a lot of these peaks traveling past you every second. Gamma rays, on the other hand, are roughly, blah, peaks per second. Let's see, that's millions, billions, trillions, quadrillions, 10 quintillion peaks per second. So you can imagine that there's a lot of these things coming past you. All right, so relationships are key. This is the main thing that we're doing when we're doing science, is we're looking for the relationships between these two. And yeah, there's some math that goes with it, but the math comes from the relationships, not the other way around. So the question I want you to pause the video and think about is, as the wavelength increases, what happens to the frequency? Does it increase as well, or does it decrease? So as the wavelength increases, what happens to the frequency? Pause the video, mark it on your sheet. All right, well, remember that radio had a very long wavelength, but a very short or low frequency. So as the wavelength increases, then the frequency decreases. So they are like this, okay? Always try to think about these proportions going like that. So we can write this way. As the wavelength goes up, then the value of this whole fraction goes down, and so frequency gets less. And remember, we talked about that with just a fraction. If I start out with 1/2, so a 2 in the bottom, if I increase that number in the bottom so it becomes 1/4, the whole fraction goes down. So anytime I have things that are going like this, then I'm going to have 1 in the top and 1 in the bottom. So as wavelength goes up, frequency goes down. As wavelength goes down, frequency goes up. Okay, and then I've always got some constant of proportionality here. It might be 1, like it was with distance. It might not be. It might be something else. Now, remember, this is way too many letters to write. Wavelength has 10 letters. Frequency has almost that. So we use symbols just because we're lazy. We don't want to write out all those words. So the common symbols that we'll use for this, F is the frequency. Okay, that makes sense. This is a lowercase Greek letter, lambda, and it doesn't really matter what you call it. Most of my students call it chicken foot. Fine. You can call it smiley face if you want. It doesn't matter. As long as when you see this symbol, your brain says wavelength, because that's all that is just a shorthand for wavelength. And you're going to find that these letters don't necessarily mean the same thing in all contexts. So an M, for example, might mean mass in one context and magnitude in another. You really have to look at the relationship because it's shorthand. It's not just, you know, secret codes where we translate everything back and forth. This is the constant that we were talking about on the previous one, and it turns out that constant is the speed of light. So since the speed of light doesn't change, this is something that stays the same. Now, you never, ever, ever have to memorize constants. They will always be given to you. In this case, the speed of light is 3 × 10⁸ meters per second. All right, so as the wavelength goes up, the frequency goes down. As the wavelength goes down, the frequency goes up. So anytime they go like this, we call that inversely proportional. That's real important. You're going to see both examples of two types of proportionality. So inversely proportional. As one goes up, the other goes down. These are the science concepts. Plugging in numbers, that's the math, but I'm not a math teacher. I'm a science teacher. It is important that you understand the relationship between these. Yeah, sometimes we need to get the details, but it's much more important that you understand this inversely proportional, directly proportional, things like that. All right, so let's talk about energy then. If you think about, let's suppose that these were ping pong balls, and every time one of these peaks hits you, you're getting hit by a ping pong ball. Okay, so the ping pong ball is coming in with the same amount of energy, or the same amount of force, because they're traveling at the same speed. So with the radio, you're getting boom, 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 right? With the gamma ray, you're getting doom, 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 doom. So which one has more energy, the radio or the gamma ray? Pause the video, write it down on your sheet. Well, I'm getting hit with more of these ping pong balls every second, so the gamma ray actually has more energy. And so this actually is the major difference between the different types of light. I mean, there is no difference between radio and gamma rays and visible light. It's all light. Don't be fooled. But gamma rays have a lot more energy, and that's why they're harmful. Radio waves have a lot less energy, and so they're not harmful. The radio waves aren't even as harmful as visible light, for that matter. So let's find out the relationship between energy and frequency. So you said that gamma rays have the highest frequency, and gamma rays have the highest energy. So are they inversely proportional? As one goes up, the other goes down. Or are they directly proportional? As one goes up, the other goes up. Or if one goes down, they both go down. So pause the video, think about that. This is key. This is the important kind of concept that we're talking about throughout this whole semester. Is energy inversely proportional frequency or directly proportional frequency? All right, well, they're going up at the same time, right? As the frequency goes up with the gamma ray, the energy also goes up. So if they both go up at the same time, then they're directly proportional. And so, as always, I've got some constant. I'll always have some constant in there that you never have to memorize. But as F goes up, E goes up. As F goes down, E goes down. And then, because I'm just taking F and multiplying it by some number from that. So these are directly proportional. This is what a directly proportional equation looks like. If they're going down, if they're inversely proportional, I'm always going to have this fraction. I'm going to have one up and one down. Very, very important. Okay, the constant in this case is, it's called the Planck constant, but it's 4.6 times 10 to the minus 20 electron volts per second. Again, you do not have to memorize that. Electron volts is a common unit of energy. I mean, it's how much energy is taken to push one electron through an electromagnetic field with a strength of 1 volt. But that's not something that we're really going to worry about in this class. Just think of it as being an energy, as some energy stuffs, okay? All right, then, look on your chart on the back page, and we've got all the different types of light. Now, we're going to talk about these in detail in the next lecture, but visible light, red, green, yellow, red, orange, yellow, green, blue, violet, this just makes up a tiny, tiny sliver of all of the different types of light that's out there. And because this is all based on oscillating electromagnetic waves, we call this the electromagnetic spectrum. But we've got infrared, microwave, radio, ultraviolet, x-rays, and gamma rays. These are the 7 types of light that we generally talk about. Now, we said that radio has low energy, gamma rays have high energy. So you tell me, mark on your sheet, does radio have a high frequency or a low frequency? Does it have a long wavelength or a short wavelength? For gamma rays, does it have a high frequency or low frequency? Does it have a short wavelength or a long wavelength? Pause the video, fill out the chart. Okay, you should have seen radio has low energy. That means it has low frequency, remember, because they're both directly proportional. So they either go this way or this way. They change in the same direction. That's the important thing, not whether they're going up or down, but whether they're in the same direction or opposite directions. So since energy is directly proportional to frequency, if it's low energy, it's a low frequency as well. But then frequency and wavelength are inversely proportional. They go this way. So as the energy goes down, or the frequency goes down, then the wavelength goes up. So radio has a very long wavelength. Think about that. So as the frequency goes up, as the frequency goes down because it's energy, then the wavelength goes up. Now I'll go back over to gamma rays. It's got a high energy. So its frequency, is it going to go up or is it going to go down? Frequency is high, or energy is high. They're directly proportional, so frequency is high as well. So it's got a high frequency. All right. Wavelength, then, if the frequency goes up, they're inversely proportional. So what happens to the wavelength? The wavelength gets shorter. And you think about it. They must be very small apart. Sound effects are very important. All right, now astronomers are lazy. So we are generally going to talk about the red end of the spectrum and the blue end of the spectrum. Red, if you look over here, red has the longest wavelength. Blue, okay, technically violet, but violet's a lot harder to say. And nobody can agree on if it's violet or purple. So we talk about the blue end of the spectrum. Blue is going to have a shorter wavelength. So look at your chart then. Which of these is the reddest? And which of these is the bluest, radio or gamma? Where's the red end of the spectrum and where's the blue end of the spectrum? Pause the video, write that down. All right, yeah, radio is the red end of the spectrum because it's got long wavelength, and red, invisible, has a longer wavelength than blue. Gamma rays then are blue end of the spectrum. So ultraviolet is bluer than visible, X-ray is bluer than ultraviolet, and gamma rays are bluer than X-rays. Infrared is redder than visible. It's redder than microwave is redder than infrared, and radio is redder than microwaves. Now, another thing that we talk about, though, we don't just call these blue. So, for example, infrared is bluer than microwave. Do you see that? Because it's closer to the blue side than the microwave is. Microwave is redder than infrared. All right, good. So, one quick thing. This is Foxtrot. I thought this is kind of funny. So, kid walks into the grocery store and says, do you sell ultraviolet bull? And the guy goes, excuse me? He says, what about regular violet bull? No. Blue bull? No. Green bull? No. Yellow bull? No. Orange bull? No. Rats. Okay, I'll take a red bull. So I was hoping for something a little higher energy. And his friend said, well, at least it is an infrared bull. You would not have understood that comic strip until you saw this lecture. All right, so in summary then, three things to keep in mind. Three properties of the wave, of the light. Wavelength, it's the distance from peak to peak. Frequency, it's how many of those peaks I'm getting each second. And then energy is the amount of energy that's contained in it. Think about it, each of those peaks is having a ping pong ball that's hitting against you. Also very, very important, not only that you know these relationships, but that you understand what these relationships mean, directly proportional, inversely proportional. Critical. So wavelength is inversely proportional to frequency. As one goes up, the other goes down. Energy is directly proportional to frequency. As one goes up, the other goes up, or as one goes down, the other goes down. And then, as always, remember that all light travels at the same speed. Don't be fooled. All light travels at the speed of light. So gamma rays have more energy, but they still travel at the same speed as radio waves. All right, that's it for now. Make sure you download the light and energy practice worksheet. It's going to look like this. Blank on the back side. Fill it out, take a picture of it. Now I'm going to give you a little tip here. On the chart, we've got the wavelengths that are showing here. And it's not important that you do any calculations with this or anything like that. Just see which one is shorter and which one's longer. That's how you're going to classify each of these different types of light that's coming in here. So when you're filling in the blanks, use the wavelength and use what you know from the class about the order of which has the longest wavelength and which has the shortest wavelength. So that's the tip I'm going to give you with that. All right. So in the next lecture, guys, we're going to look at each one of those different types of light. And we're going to talk about, you know, the properties of them, what it's like, what we use it for, things like that. So most people kind of enjoy this and learning about the different kinds of light. So we'll see you next time.